we've recently seen, I mean, as I said, we are the land of the argumentative Indian and you know, the chatty Indian and all of that. But we've seen over the past few years or months an increasing kind of, you know, a lot of ideas have been met with bullets. And it's become a risky business. We had the murder of Gauri Lankesh in Bangalore. We had another journalist killed. So do you think the word imagination and expression can survive this kind? Can it survive the bullet? I mean, it's a serious assault, because it's all very well to say that, no, we will carry on, etc. But this is a very serious attack on speaking up, or speaking up for a certain set of ideas, or any idea. Should it? How does one tackle this?
Well, I think, you know, of course it's a serious problem in India, but it's a serious problem globally as well, particularly concerning journalists. I think I would say this, that in India, I personally believe that, as I said, in a pluralistic, a multi-religious India, and I think that anyone, any government, any politicians, any individual who preaches or says anything which will spread hatred of religion is to be deplored, frankly. And I believe and I hope that India's tradition is strong enough, and I've often written and said this, to prevent this going too far, to restore that tradition to its rightful place.
And you're hopeful?
Yes. Because I believe it's a very, very strong tradition. And because I've seen in India things going wrong, but coming back into the center again.
Mark, tell us a little more about, you know, you speak in this book again about, you know, how you had extensive conversations with prime ministers, from Indira Gandhi all the way to Manmohan Singh. So take us a little bit into the minds of whoever you find the most fascinating or the most exasperating, and, you know, anything that you might want to share with us.
Well, let me tell you about two incidents. One which happened to be in Pakistan, where General Zia had conceived a violent dislike of me. And I had difficulty in my reporting in concealing my dislike. I had to hold myself in check not to conceal my dislike of him. And I was once called up by his spokesman, who was a very good friend of mine, funnily enough. And we had our discussion. I got my story, whatever it was. And then he said, stay for tea and samosas. I said, look, I've got a lunch engagement. I can't. Anyhow, this went on and on until eventually, suddenly, he looked at his watch and he said, Achcha, you can go now. So I said, what's all this about? He said, well, the thing is this, that at this time of day, General Zia comes out of his office, which was on the floor below, and says his prayer. And, you know, he kneels on the ground. And knowing what you thought of him, I was afraid you would kick him up the arse.
That was a narrow escape for Zia.
That was one of them. And another one was... you know, you again, you try not to influence your judge, allow your likes and dislikes to influence your judgment. But I was very fond of two of the Janata Dal politicians, Chaudhry Devi Lal and Chaudhry Charan Singh. And Chaudhry Devi Lal, I once went to see Chaudhry Devi Lal, and the only time I ever interfered in politics was because B.P. Singh's brother, Sanpaksh, wanted to get into parliament. And B.P., because he was so keen to preserve his reputation, wasn't going to have any Bible teacher or anything like that. So I saw Chaudhry Saab, and Chaudhry Saab was in a very bad mood. And I said to him, I'll try and do this in Hindi for I said to Kya Chaudhry Saab, aap gusa hai. He said, Ore babre, ye table work mein nahi pasand karta hoon. So I said to him, but aaj ki table work bahut mahatvapoorn tha. Aap to manifesto likh raha tha. He looked at me and he said, Bewakoof, aap kya sochta hai? मैं गिन नहीं सकता हूँ कि मैं कितना चुनाव लड़ा, लेकिन मैं आपको एक आश्वासन दे सकता हूँ कि मैं एक मैनिफेस्टो कभी नहीं पढ़ा. And this was terribly sad for you, you know. So I was very, very, very fond of Chaudhry Saab. And I liked them because, and particularly Chaudhry Devi Lal, because he was real grassroots politician.
Before we close, may I request our chief editor, Mr. Rajkamal Jha, to please present a small memento to Mark, which he may find interesting.
It's a picture.